Hello, Kodiaks and Kodiak families. My name is Angela Jones, and I am your family engagement specialist for Kate Bond Middle School. Today, we are participating in our community partner spotlight. This is our time for us to take a moment to say thank you to our local businesses who have supported us and have been friends with Kate Bond Middle School. At this time, I would like to introduce Mr. Stephen Coletta. He is a restaurant owner to the renowned restaurant Coletta's here in Memphis, Tennessee. Take it away, Kodiak Channel.
Hi, my name is Deirdre.
Hi, my name is Dylan.
Hi, my name is Isabella.
Hi, my name is Cesaria.
And you're watching the Kodiak Channel.
Today we are joined by Stephen Coletta, owner of Coletta's restaurant here in Bartlett and two other locations in Memphis. Please tell us about your restaurant, Coletta's.
Well, first, thank you for having me. Kate Bond is right around the corner from us, so great school. Coletta's is actually Memphis's oldest restaurant since 1923. It was my great-grandfather that started it. We are almost 25 years old here at the Appling Road location, which is the one around the corner from y'all. One of the main things is we make just about everything ourselves. A lot of restaurants these days buy everything kind of pre-packaged and then resell it. And that's one of our differentiating points. We make our own sauces, our own salad dressings. We make our own bread, our own pizza crust, ravioli, meatballs. I can go on and on and on.
So this is just one tray, but usually, you know, pre-pandemic or post-pandemic, this will be just full.
Stick to tradition, especially being almost 100 years old. We'll be celebrating our centennial anniversary in two more years, 100 years. So very, very proud of that. And we're just kind of trying to keep the tradition going.
What inspired you to do what you do, and how did you start your business?
Again, my great-grandfather is the one that started Coletta's a long, long time ago. So then my grandfather got in the business, my father got in the business, and I actually literally grew up in the restaurant business. I remember being 5-6 years old, and I would be the busboy in the summertime. You know, when I was out of school, I would go in with my father, and I literally remember bussing tables and barely seeing over the little bus cart that we had. And you know, my father would give me $5 for the whole day, which I thought was great. Not so much today. I guess the main thing, that the restaurant business is a lot of hard work, and that's why a lot of people don't succeed at it, because you have to love it. to be successful at it. A lot of challenges, a lot of hours, a lot of things go into, you know, being successful. And I guess it's just in my blood, you know, love it. Every day is different. Being proud that we're so old kind of keeps me motivated from day to day.
What does a typical job day look like?
There's no typical day in the restaurant business. Every day is different. And again, that's one of the things that I love about the restaurant business. You know, never a dull moment. There's always something to do. You know, we do a lot of catering, and we have some in-house banquet rooms. So, you know, for us, it is literally, you know, coming in early and starting on the lunch caterings, and then the lunch rush. And then after that, it's starting on the dinner caterings, and then the dinner rush, and the in-house banquet rooms. And then, you know, between all of that, you have to do all your other stuff as well. So never a dull moment. A typical day is lots of hours, lots of work, but, you know, luckily I enjoy doing it.
What is the most challenging part of your job?
That's a tough one. I guess it's two parts. Me personally, most small business owners wear many hats. You know, here I do a lot of different things every day. And that can be very challenging, kind of juggling the different tasks. You know, I do a lot of the cooking for our catering division. I do a lot of the financial and bookkeeping part of it as well. I actually try to stay in touch with our customers. So when we get calls in for catering or in-house banquets, I like to be the one to talk to them as well. So and there's a lot of other things. So juggling all the responsibilities is probably the hardest part of my job, for sure. The restaurant industry, on the other hand, has a lot of challenges. There are so many places to eat these days, and that is the biggest challenge. You know, how do you differentiate yourself to stand out and make people want to come to your place? And, you know, I think we do that by, you know, making our own food. You know, we have kind of a niche there that not a lot of places make their own food. They might make one or two items, but not most items. In a nutshell, that is it. But tons of challenges in the restaurant business in general. Lots of other ones as well.
What are the qualities someone would need to work in your business?
You know, we are in the hospitality industry. So, you know, different restaurants have different qualifications. But my biggest is just a people person or somebody that sincerely wants to help others. Somebody that has a positive attitude. You know, we can teach all the, you know, all the basics and all everything else, but the very most important thing is attitude. You know, wanting to do a good job and wanting to take care of the customers, and unfortunately, that is becoming increasingly hard to find. But that is definitely all it takes, a great attitude.
How has COVID-19 affected you and your business?
COVID-19 has definitely affected the restaurant business pretty severely. Right now we are at 25% capacity restrictions, which means, you know, if we had 200 people capacity in our restaurant, now it is only 50 people that we can have. So it kind of limits what we can do, which limits our revenue, which limits our ability to pay our vendors and employees and everything. We have been very fortunate. We actually have a freestanding location that we bought a long time ago. So we do not have the rent payments like a lot of places do. And that's huge. I feel very sorry for the places that have rent obligations in addition to, the limitations on capacity. It's been a tough year, but with the vaccine, we are hoping that in a couple months, 2021 is going to be a much, much better year.
Have you ever worked at home before COVID-19?
No. The restaurant business doesn't lend itself well to working at home, for sure. When you're a small business owner, restaurant owner, it is very hands-on. So, we are one industry where I don't think that will change after the pandemic. If you're not here at the restaurant, then things go wrong. So I foresee us being one of the few industries where, staying at home will never be an option.
Does Coletta have any special events you would like to let our Kodiak family know about?
Not really any events that I can think of. But several services. Don't feel like getting out and coming to get takeout, then we are definitely on DoorDash, so we can deliver to you. If there are any special events that require food, we can definitely cater your event. We are open 7 days a week, lunch and dinner, 7 days a week. We actually have two in-house banquet rooms as well. Both of them seat 50 people. Well, this is post-pandemic. 50 people, or we can open the partition and create one big banquet room that seats up to 100. We do concessions as well, so you might see us at the Liberty Bowl stadium if you go to a Memphis Tigers football game, or you might see us at the 4th of July fireworks show, at Bartlett or wherever we might be. So we have several opportunities for y'all to see us, for sure.
Well, thank you, Mr. Coletta, for speaking with us today and for all of your support. We're looking forward to visiting Coletta soon, and we wish you all the best.
Nice. Well, thank y'all for having me, and I love the Kodiak Channel and y'all's class. Wish y'all much luck. And again, thank you all for having me.
Thank you,
Mr. Coletta.
Thank y'all.
Thank you so much, Mr. Coletta, for joining us and for being featured on our Community Partner Spotlight. Kate Bond Middle School thanks you for your donations and your kindness. And I encourage our Kodiak family members to please pop in and visit Mr. Coletta's restaurant and be sure to tell him that the Kodiak Channel sent you. Take care, everyone. Good night.